concern for the
okay.
hands-on workshop by Tuna International. V Raptor, that is Red Raptor new edition, then by Mr. Raj.
நம்ம பார்க்க போகிற டெமோ வந்து தேர்ட் ஜெனரேஷன் ரெட் கேமராவுடைய இது இது லேட்டஸ்ட் இன்ஸ்டால்மெண்ட். ஏற்கனவே வந்து பார்த்தீங்கன்னா ரெண்டு தலைமுறை கேமராக்கள் வந்து ஏற்கனவே ப்ரொடியூஸ் பண்ணி ரொம்ப ஆக்சுவலாக ஒரு சினிமா டிஜிட்டலாக மாறதுக்கு மிக மிகப்பெரிய பெரும்பங்கு வைத்தது வந்து ரெட்டோடைய இதுதான்.
அவங்க தான் வந்து பார்த்தீங்கன்னா 4K ரெசல்யூஷன், ரா வீடியோ இந்த மாதிரியான ஃபீச்சர்ஸ் எல்லாம் அறிமுகப்படுத்தி உங்களுக்கு வந்து ஒரு டிஜிட்டல் சினிமாட்டோகிராஃபி எவல்யூஷன் ஸ்டார்ட் பண்ணுறதுக்கு ஒரு மிக முக்கியமான காரணமாக இருந்தாங்க. இப்போ வந்து அவங்க தேர்ட் ஜெனரேஷன் கேமரா, தட் இஸ் வி ராப்டர் கொமோடோ, அதனுடைய டெமோ நீங்கள் பார்க்கலாம். இதுக்கு மிக முக்கியமான காரணமாக இருந்தது அமித் பண்டாரி ஆஃப் டினோ இன்டர்நேஷ்னல். வி வெல்கம் அமித் பண்டாரி. அதே மாதிரி அவங்களுடைய ஃபாதர் மிஸ்டர் தீபக் சார், அவரையும் இங்கே மேடைக்கு அழைக்கிறோம். சோனு அவர்கள் மேடைக்கு வாங்க. அண்ட் சினிமாட்டோகிராஃபர் ராஜ் ஃப்ரம் ரெட் இன்டர்நேஷ்னல், ப்ளீஸ். திவாகர் அவர்கள்,
இதுக்கு மெயின் காரணம் இருந்தது மிஸ்டர் சிஜி ராஜ்குமாரும் நம்ம ட்ரெஷரர் சக்தி சரவணனும். We have to clap for them.
சக்தி சார், ஃபியூ வேர்ட்ஸ்.
அனைவருக்கும் வணக்கம். இன்னும் தியேட்டர் வந்து இன்னும் ஃபில் ஆகலை, அதுதான் வந்து ஒரு கன்சர்ன். நெக்ஸ்ட் டைம் வந்து இந்த மாதிரியான டெமோக்கெலாம் இன்னும் நிறைய பேர் வந்துருந்து சப்போர்ட் பண்ணணும். ஓகே, த ஃப்ளோர் இஸ் யுவர் சார்.
தேங்க்யூ எவ்ரி ஒன். தேங்க்யூ சிகா ஃபார் திஸ் வண்டர்ஃபுல் ஆப்பர்ச்சுனிட்டி. Thank you, Rajkumar sir, Shakti sir, for giving this opportunity to us. And my name is Raj Pedinti. I work as a regional operations manager for Red Digital Cinema. And we are here in collaboration with our master dealers, Tinno International. They are master dealers for entire India region. For the next 1 hour, we are going to talk the new generation camera, red cameras, Rajkumar sir told us, DSMC 3. We are going to talk about the first camera in DSMC 3 lineup, that is Raptor. After the format is going to be, I am going to give a presentation for 40 minutes to 1 hour, and after the presentation we can have a discussion, we can have question and answer session, we can take as much time as we want, and then we can have hands-on shooting experience in groups with the camera. So before going, I'd like to introduce myself. As I said, my name is Raj Pedinta. I worked as I started off in Telugu film industry as assistant of Mr. Jainan Vincent. Most of you might have known his name. I started off as like that around 12 years back. Before that, I got trained at Red Studios, Los Angeles. And then I came back to India. At that time, there were no red cameras literally in India. I was one of the first evangelists of digital photography in India. I have seen literally the shift from, you know, film to digital, witnessed in front of my eyes, and, you know, perpetrated and helped digital cinematography to take off in India. So afterwards, I worked in different capacities with Red as a consultant, as an employee. Right now, I am as a permanent employee of Red. And apart from that, I directed a Z5 Telugu series called Chadarangam. That basically I try to balance my technical life and writer director life. That's about me. And before getting into the boring theory part, I'll show you a few show reels so that we'll start off with some cheer. So, majority of the footage you have seen, that is not from this camera, but that it is from, the footage is from the previous generation cameras. The cameras that majority, most of you must have shot with, the Monstros, Gemini, Helium. So, they're all DSMC 2 cameras. Before we get into the DSMC 3 presentation, V-Raptor presentation, that is, we are going to cover first product intro. I'm going to introduce the product to you, the DSMC 3 V-Raptor to you. Later, we are going to talk about body features. What are the improvements from previous generation cameras? What is the difference between the Monstro Helium DSMC 2 lineup and this camera? And later we are going to talk about imaging developments, as in terms of image. What are the changes? Is there any change? And if there is, what are the changes? What are the improvements from the previous generation? And then red code. There is a subtle difference between the red code, the way you used to use the red code on DSMC 2 cameras and the red code right now introduced on these cameras. They simplified it, they made it much easier. It's not that complicated anymore. So we're going to talk in detail about red code. Afterwards, accessories. The most important thing, how we are going to rig the camera. The same small camera can be made it into a very big camera, very accessible for, high-end shoots. How is it going to happen? How to make this camera into a production camera? This camera can be made into a small, independent camera sized camera, and at the same time it can be used on very big productions, which is being done in Hollywood right now. So before getting into this, just to give you a brief on what is RED, for some people who might not be knowing what is RED. RED is an American cinema camera manufacturing company. We started off in 2006. At that time, there used to be 1080p, 1080i digital cameras that used to go for, $100,000, $150,000. That is, in today's exchange rate, we are talking about 70 lakhs to 1 crore for 1080i, 1080p cameras at that time, 2005, 2006. At that time, we came up with this groundbreaking specifications of 4K shooting RAW for $17,500. So that is literally one-sixth of what 1080i cameras used to cost at that time. So we are basically, as I always say, there are companies, majority of the companies, until RED came to the picture, they used to be marketing driven. As in, even if the research and development wing of that particular camera company, if they are ready with, for example, 4K in 2005, 2006, 2007, they will not release 4K because they'll keep it, for future releases. Though the technology is ready, though the computing power is ready, they used to keep it with them so that the marketing will say, instead of R&D, the marketing will dictate when to release one particular technology for the, users, cinematographers in our case. But RED is a company which is driven by R&D team. If the R&D has a major breakthrough, that is how it is supposed to happen. Of course, if I release, for example, today, if I have a breakthrough in 20K camera, I cannot release 20K camera because the post-production is not possible on a 20K camera even. So basically keeping the ecosystem in mind, that is one major thing. And second thing is, it should be as latest as it can be. That is the idea. As latest as it can be, so that the imaging will be better. At that time, the other companies, they are happy with the emulsion. They are not ready to shift from emulsion to the film to digital. And some companies, they are happy with the 1080p, 1080i cameras for broadcast. So at that time, we Jim Jannard is the founder of the company. He sold, he used to be the owner of a sunglasses company called Oakley. He sold the company, and at the age of 60, he risked everything and he started this company. And rest is history. After 15 years, we're talking about, the third generation of those cameras. First RED camera is called RED1, RED1 MX.
And then second generation cameras are called DSMC. DSMC, that is the first generation of this cuboid design. First Red 1 and Red 1 MX used to be like a tank. They used to be, you know, majority of you must have seen the camera, Red 1. And then DSMC lineup. DSMC, the full form of DSMC is a digital stills and motion capture. The idea is, if you are shooting, for example, this camera is an 8K camera. That means in megapixel terms, we're talking about 35 megapixel. That means if you are shooting, for example, 8K, 60 frames or 24 frames or 120 frames, if you pull one still out of that video, you are even if you print it, it is going to be as good as 35 megapixel raw still frame. That is because of the resolution we are giving, one, and that is also because of the raw file format we are using. Apart from these two, we came up with, from DSMC lineup, we came up with this, you know, smaller form factor cameras that had always been at the heart of the design. The camera should be small is the idea. The reason why we went with smaller form factor cameras is, in digital, when you changed from film to digital, film had its own limitations. Unless, because film is majorly mechanical, film is not electronic. Film is majorly, of course, there will be component, electronic components, but majorly film is mechanical. Because it is mechanical, the size cannot be reduced into, you know, it only, there will be limitation in terms of size. After a point, you cannot make it into a small camera. But it is not the case with digital cinema cameras. So that, you know, the handheld shots, the whenever you handle it, whether with the help of a steady cam or a gimbal or you want to go handheld, it is going to make the cinematographers, the operators, the cinematography team's life easier. This is the feedback we got after our first Red One camera from Hollywood cinematographers, Hollywood filmmakers, and we wanted to go with, you know, smaller form factor cameras. That is when Epic Dragon, Scarlett came to picture. That is our first generation DSMC cameras. Later, the DSMC lineup upgraded to second generation, that is DSMC 2. On DSMC 2, we've got Helium, Monstro, Gemini, and Dragon X. These are the names of the sensors at that time. And DSMC 2 is a form factor of a camera. Now, after this DSMC 2, we came up with the first of the DSMC 3 lineup. This is V-Raptor. Now, with this background, you might ask, what exactly is this? This is Komodo. This is neither DSMC 2 nor DSMC 3. The reason why it is a 4-inch, almost 4-inch by 4-inch by 4-inch cube. If you remove everything, you will feel like, you know, it's a big-sized Rubik's cube. That's designed for one specific purpose of, you know, making smallest possible camera, but at the same time giving the maximum benefits Red offers, like raw image, more than 5K resolution, that is 6K resolution, it is capable of 6K resolution. And apart from that, greatest benefit of Komodo is shooting global shutter. That means, originally, the original intention of designing Komodo, it's not DSMC 3 officially, it will come somewhere between DSMC 2 and DSMC 3. The original intention of designing Komodo was, you know, to create, the drone camera, which can intercut with your main camera. Previously, what used to happen, that the GoPros and all the action cameras used to, you know, we used to fly and we used to shoot main with lot of resolution, lot of dynamic range. Your main footage will be extraordinary and it will not cut. When I say cut, it's not edit, it's about color. In terms of color, it will not match with, you know, these action cameras cannot match the dynamic range nor the color science of the main cameras. So, the reason why we've designed is for that, to create a small form factor camera with maximum Red benefits, Red raw, and Red resolution, Red dynamic range, at the same time useful for, you know, drones, action cams, rigging, mounting, making, because of the size of the camera, when it is reduced, the kind of shots that will be possible, will entirely, the scope will be entirely, you know, changing. That we understood when, you know, these GoPro mounted shots and, you know, all these sorts of body rigs, all sorts of where previously cameras cannot be mounted, can be mounted with action cameras. But the problem with action cameras is they're not good quality. They're not, they will not give good quality image. So we've designed this for exactly that purpose. But when after this camera is released, as I said, it's a 6K Super 35. 16 stop dynamic range, red raw, IPP2 color science. Basically, it's a miniature version of professional camera. Because of these features, it's not just being used by bigger production houses as a fly cam or as a crash cam or as an action cam. We are witnessing a small, you know, independent filmmakers using this as their main camera. So I'll always say this, it's a big camera for small people and small camera for big guys. You can have multiple cameras for your action episodes if you're on a big production. If you're a small production, you can use it as your main camera. So that's about Komodo.